for the equivalent, the key term equivalent set, we have to compare two sets, set A and set B for this situation. Set A is equivalent to set B, means that set A and set B contains the same number of element. Same number, that means the counting, the total number of the member are the same. For example, set A is a set of X that is a vowel. And if you make in the roster form, if you rewrite A in a roster form, so A is the set of A, E, I, O, U. Okay, we have total of 5 members. So I can write in here like N of A equals 5. And for set B is a set of X such that X is a natural number, this one, the natural number or the counting number. And X between 3 and 7, including 3, including 7. So I can write set B as the set of the number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How many members of the B? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 different members. So N of B equals 5. By nature of set A and set B, they are totally different as the member, each member, but the total number of the members are the same. For this case, as long as the counting, how many members in set A, that number is the same as the number of the members in set B. Set A and set B, we call it, they are equivalent sets. So we can say set A and set B, they are equivalent because N of A equals 5, which is the same as N of B, even though they are totally different natures. Equal sets, set A is equal to set B if set A and set B contain exactly the same elements regardless of order or possible repetition of elements. And the notation to represent the equal set, just straightforward, set A equals set B. Okay, and the difference here between the equal set and the equivalent set, for the equal set, exactly the same member one by one. For the equivalent set, the total number are the same. Okay, the total number of the element are the same. For example, the previous example that we did when we worked on, when we went through the equivalent set, as A equals A, E, I, O, U. Okay, and we know that N of A equals 5, right, from the previous example, and B is the set of 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. N of B equals 5. So for this case, since N A equals N B, so A and B are equivalent. But not equal. Okay, not equal. Why is not equal? Because you compare one by one. One set, they are letters. The other set, they are numbers. They are already different. And the other situation, if you have something like, if the set A is a set of 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, and set B is 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. You see the repeating part? You have two of them, 3, 2 of them, and 4, 2 of them. Where set A, same thing. If you clean it up, basically you have A as the set of 1, 2, 3, and 4. Clean up a little bit, write in a better one. So A is just a set of 1, 2, 3, and 4. While the set B in the cleaner version is just the set of 1, 2, 3, 4. Compare the cleaner version and the cleaner version. They are exactly the same member by member. In this case, we can say A and B are equal. And we use the notation A equals B. If A and B are equal, they are also equivalent. Okay, so I'm gonna put the note up here. Okay, so if A and B are equal, then A and B are equivalent. Okay. So for A and B, that are equivalent, A might not be equal to B. Okay, so like this example, they are equivalent but not equal. But if they are equal, they are also equivalent. So I'm gonna put a note here. Also equivalent. So that's the equal and equivalent. So let's look at the example. This time we're gonna determine the given sets are equal, equivalent, or neither. Okay, the cardinal number is one of the tools to help you determine whether they are equal, equivalent, and so forth. So for number one, set A is the set of the members 3, 5, and 7. Set B is set of 5, 3, 7, 7. If you rewrite it, we write set B and the repeating one, 7 and 7, we just write it once. So we would get 5, 3, 7, or write in the same order or in the nice order, can be 3, 5, 7, exactly the same as the set A. And also the following part, the cardinal number of A equals 3, cardinal number of B equals 3. They are equal by default. So then both A and B are equal and equivalent. Okay. The next example, set A is a set of 4, 6, 10, 12, 35. So the cardinal number of the A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 different members. And set B contains 35, 7, 77, 83, 90, and 110. So the cardinal number of the B is 5 different numbers, or cardinal number is 5 because you have 5 different members. They don't look the same as you see. So A and B are not equal, but they are equivalent. Okay, for this case, not equal because they don't match the one by one, number by number, or element by element, but the total number of the members are the same. And the last one, part three, set A contains 1, 2, and 3. Set B contains 1, 2, 3, and 4. Well, one has 3 members, the other has 4. Very obvious that A not equal to B. That means not equal. That's a way to explain it. And if you make a list of the members, if you look for the cardinal number of the members, so cardinal number of the set, sorry. So that means N of A, or the cardinal number of the A is 3, because total number of the members 3, and the cardinal number of set B is 4. That the N of A not equal to N of B, This one tells you that both sets they are not equivalent. Okay, equivalent. So this case can be neither case.